So we just saw how to evaluate arithmetic expressions, like 1 plus 1 evaluates to 2. But we can also consider more complicated expressions, like 1 plus 2 is equal to 3. We can imagine evaluating this part recursively and getting the answer 3, and then deciding that 3 is equal to 3. So this whole thing evaluates to true. And these may not seem like very complicated or powerful expressions yet, but these are really the building blocks that we're going to use to make a working web browser. However, what if I give you an expression like this? We want to check and see if x plus 2 is equal to 3. What should this return? Actually, we're not certain. If x is currently equal to 1, then it should definitely return 3. But if x is something else, like negative 300, then this won't work out quite as well. We need to know the value of x to figure this out. And in fact, we need to know the current value of x because a lot of variables change. In fact, we can see the same sort of thing in natural language. Here I've written out a sentence, "The king of France is bald," that is syntactically entirely valid. And we can imagine trying to figure out if this sentence is true or false. But knowing what it means, whether it represents the world correctly or not, depends on knowing the current state of the world. For example, as of the time of this recording, there is no king of France. France is not a monarchy. So it's not clear what it means to talk about the hair of the king of France when there is no king of France. Similarly, if you're writing a Python program and you write x plus 1 equals equals 2 and you haven't yet defined x, if there is no king of France, it's not clear what this means, and the Python interpreter is going to give you a runtime error. Runtime error if x is not yet defined. That's not the only kind of runtime error. There are many ways things can go wrong, but it's one of the most common. Let's just briefly review evaluating expressions in context in the form of a quiz. Try it out. I've written a 6-line Python program, and I would really like it to print out true 3 times. So each of these print statements should have its argument evaluate to true. What I'd like you to do is fill in each blank so that that happens, but you can only fill in blanks with x, y, or z. This is kind of a puzzle. Can you solve constraints or do backwards reasoning to figure out how things would have to go?